1-0. Ignition sequence start.
We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
I think it means that the job of landing something on the moon where there's no atmosphere and using a rocket to slow it up and having the equipment still work is a very difficult job.
We've been brought in here by Stanley Kubrick to more or less ensure the scientific integrity of the film, to make sure that it's very, very close in reality, but still we want to make certain that it has a base of reality.
Before the end of the 60s, we will see a man in the moon, to the moon, an American, and we're very proud that our country continues to produce these young men who go so far and carry with them so much.
To put people on the moon and with enough fuel to enable them to return safely home to Earth requires a still larger and more powerful rocket, however.
It's going to take some time, and I think we have to recognize it. They secured these large boosters, which have led to their being first in Sputnik and led to their first putting their man in space. We are, I hope, going to be able to carry out our efforts with due regard to the problem of the life of the man involved this year. But we are behind.
However, let us imagine for a moment that the many problems have been solved. We are ready to begin our first voyage to the moon.
It is quite possible that an aggressor nation that dominates space will then dominate the world.
We're in the final assembly building of the LEM. Stanley Kubrick and I have set ourselves several objectives. We hope to convey to the public the wonder and beauty and promise of the new age of exploration, which is opening up for the human race.
Father, here we are on the LEM ship, and one can almost imagine we're on our way to the moon, or we've arrived at the moon, as a matter of fact.
Can you believe it? Can you realize that we, that you and I, that all of us, have actually begun the exploration of another world? We have taken the first historic step into our solar system.
H1.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
H2.
One small step for man, one giant leap for man.
We, the crew of Apollo 11, are privileged to represent the United States in our first attempt to take man to another heavenly body.
Man walks on the moon! Man walks on the moon!
The first man from Earth walked on the morning, and the suspense here in London is unbelievable.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston.
Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
Now step off the LEM now.
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you, over.
That would be an honor.
Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House, and this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made in the whole history of man. All the people on this earth are truly one. One in their pride in what you have done. And one in our prayers that you will return safely to Earth.
NASA.
the National Aeronautics and Space Administration.